So another one of the big name players that were out there and their team made them available is now off the market. Matt Zuccarello was traded to the Dallas Stars in exchange for a second round pick that I believe turns into a first round pick if Dallas wins more than two playoff rounds, and then a third round pick in the 2020 NHL draft. Now, I honestly thought that the New York Rangers could get a lot more for Matt Zuccarello, you know, just considering Detroit got a second round pick and Madison Bowie for Nick Jensen. And Zuccarello, I think, is a much more significant piece than Nick Jensen, so I'm very intrigued with this, and I think Dallas really got a very, very good deal to increase their forward depth and really give some help to Jamie Benn and Tyler Seguin. Matt Zuccarello, over his career, has been a consistent 50-point scorer. He broke the 60-point mark on one occasion in the 2015-16 season with the New York Rangers with 61 points, and this year in 46 games with the Rangers, he has 11 goals and 26 assists for 37 points on a pretty bad New York team. So he's still putting up some very good numbers, and I think he's going to be a pretty huge piece for this Dallas Stars team. And like I said, it's going to take a lot of pressure off of Tyler Seguin, and like Jamie Benn, I'm not quite sure where they're going to play Zuccarello. I don't really think they're going to stack the first line. I think they're going to keep it as it is with Radulov playing with Jamie Benn and Tyler Seguin, but I definitely think Matt Zuccarello is going to be a huge, huge piece and definitely a very nice fit on their second line. In my opinion, this move definitely sets the tone for other teams trying to break into that playoff spot and, you know, battling for those final two wildcard spots in the Western Conference. Colorado, you know, sits tied with them in points, and I think Colorado now is maybe going to be pressured into making a move. They were one of the teams that were rumored to be interested in Matt Zuccarello, but currently Dallas Stars sitting in the first wildcard spot, 61 games played, 30-26-5 with 65 points. Like I said, tied in points with the Avalanche, but they do have one game in hand. So it's going to be very, very interesting to see what the Minnesota Wild, the Coyotes, the Blackhawks, and Canucks all do in terms of reacting to this move, because those are teams that are battling for these final wildcard spots. And I definitely like this move from the Dallas Stars standpoint, and I think the fans should like it as well, because it's showing that your GM wants to make it into the postseason and not only get there, but do some significant damage. And you're going to need more than just two and three really good players on your forward group. You're going to need more guys that can score and, you know, to take the pressure off of the big guns on this team, and I think that trade is going to do that. And I honestly wouldn't be surprised if the Dallas Stars aren't done yet, because they still have Julius Honka, who I thought would be in this trade for sure once I saw that Matt Zuccarello was traded to the Dallas Stars. But I really do think they got a bargain here, and I think Rangers fans should maybe be a little bit disappointed, because I honestly thought they would have got a guaranteed first round pick, or if not that, then a pretty decent prospect or a guy like a Julius Honka. So I definitely think the Dallas Stars could still dangle around their first rounder and Julius Honka in some trade talks or future first round picks if they really want to go all in this season and try to make a push in the Western Conference. It's now going to be interesting to see what the New York Rangers are going to get back for Kevin Hayes if they do decide to take that route and trade him, because I think this kind of sets the tone for the market. Like, this is a pretty big name player who a lot of teams were interested in, and in my opinion, like I said multiple times in the video, I think Dallas really did get a bargain on him, considering some of the other trades that have happened so far, you know, around this trade deadline, like the Nick Jensen trade, you know, Detroit getting a second round pick for a guy like him. But yeah, this really did shock me. I honestly thought that Dallas would have to give up a little bit more to get Matt Zuccarello, but I think Dallas fans should be ecstatic with this. And if I'm a Rangers fan, I'm not too upset, because Matt Zuccarello isn't a part of your future. You're a rebuilding team, and he's not really going to be a part of what you're trying to do. So honestly, you can never have too many draft picks, and you know, you still have the potential to get that first rounder if the Dallas Stars do end up winning two playoff rounds, and I think Zuccarello definitely could help them do that. But like I said, I would not be surprised if the Dallas Stars are not done making moves. So with that being said, I hope you guys all enjoyed the video, and make sure to let me know down in the comment section what you think of this trade, especially from a Stars fan and a New York Rangers fan's perspective. So with that being said, I hope you guys all enjoyed the video. If you did, please make sure to drop a like on it and subscribe to the channel for daily NHL content, and I will see you guys all in the next video.